Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet the Desi mesh cardigan. For this cardigan, it is super comfortable and perfect for summer. So I make size small for this cardigan. But don't worry if you guys wear different size. In this video, I also show you how to measure it on your body and how to make it bigger step by step. For making this cardigan, you guys can use any type of yarn that's good for wearing in the summer. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the front part of the cardigan. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 52. It is equal 8 inches length. If you guys want your front part bigger, please add more chains. Make sure that your foundation chain is the even number. After you got 52 chains, and this is how I'm measuring the front part of the cardigan on my body. So for this foundation chain is the length of my front part. It is measuring from the middle part of my chest until my underarm. Like I said, if you guys want it bigger, please add more chains and measuring it on your body like I show you. After you got your desired fit, next we are going to make the mesh stitch. For row 1, skip 5 chains and make double crochet into the 6th chain. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. So for these chains that we skip also count as a stitch. Next, chain 1, skip 1 chain and make double crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 chain and make double crochet into the next chain until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the mesh stitch looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 3. Remember, for this chain 3 also count as a stitch. Turn your work. Skip this chain space and make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1, skip the chain space and make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this by chain 1, skip the chain space and make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch until you have one last stitch, then we meet you back again. Thank you. After you had one last stitch, it is the chain 3 stitch, then we are going to chain 1. You can turn your work like this so you can see the foundation chains. So skip this chain and make the bulk crochet into the next chain. And this is what the second row of the mesh stitch looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 12. It is equal 4 inches high. Then we meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 12. And this is what it looks like on my body. If you guys want your cardigan more longer, please add more rows. For the next part, we are going to make the V-neck. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 13, make the mesh stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches, next we are going to make the crease. So for this last double crochet, you don't have to chain 1. Just continue make the double crochet into the next double crochet stitch. And for this chain stitch or the last stitch, we are going to skip it. Next, for row 14, chain 2. Remember, for chain 2, we don't count as a stitch. Turn your work. Then we are going to make the crease by skip this double crochet stitch and then continue make the double crochet into the next double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then continue make the mesh stitch until you reach the end of the row and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 15, make the mesh stitch until you have 1 last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you have 1 last stitch, like I said, for this chain 2, we don't count as a stitch. For this last double crochet stitch, you don't have to chain 1, just make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch. And this is what it looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 14 and row 15 until you reach row 19. Then I will meet you back again. this is what it looks like after you reach row 19. You must have 7 rows of decreasing stitch. Next, for row 20, chain 2. Turn your work and make double crochet into the stitch near chain 2. Then continue make the mesh stitch until you reach the end of the row. For row 21, make the mesh stitch until you reach the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. And now I have 7 stitches of double crochet. It is equal 5 inches, is the measurement of my shoulder. If you guys want to make it smaller, please keep decreasing by repeat row 14 and 15. And after you reach your shoulder measurement, then stop decreasing and repeat row 20 and 21. Next, for row 22 until row 34, just make the mesh stitch, no decrease. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 34, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what my front part of the cardigan looks like. You must have 34 rows in total. It is equal 13 inches high. If you guys want your front part more longer, please add more rows. And this is what it looks like when I try it on my body. And this is what my shoulder part looks like. Next, please repeat the same thing to the other side. Next, we are going to make the back part of the cardigan. For the back part of the cardigan, please make 101 chains. It is equal 16 inches length. If you guys make different size, please take the measurement of the front part of your cardigan, plus it together, and then you have the number of your back part measurement. And after you have made 101 chain, and that we are going to make the mesh stitch for 32 rows. It is equal 12.5 inches high. Remember, for the front part and the back part of the cardigan, you must have the same number of the rows. So for my front part, I have 34 rows in total. And for my back part, I make 32 rows and 2 more rows. It is for the back shoulder part. So to get the measurement of the back shoulder part, you have to count the number of the stitches of the front part. For me, I have 17 stitches of the double crochet, and then count 17 stitches the same number to the back part. And count 2 more stitches and mark it. For these 2 more stitches, it is for decrease to make the curve at the back neckline. And then don't forget to count the same number to the other side. Next, we are going to make the back shoulder part. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 1, chain 3, turn your work, and make the mesh stitch until you have one last stitch from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near the stitch marker, we are going to make decrease. So for this last double crochet, you don't have to chain 1. Just continue make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 2. Turn your work. Skip double crochet stitch and chain space, and then continue make double crochet into the next double crochet stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then continue make mesh stitch until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what my back shoulder part looks like. Next, we are going to make the other side. We are going to attach the yarn into the stitch that we mark. Make sure that you attach the yarn into the double crochet stitch. Next, for row 1, chain 2, skip the chain space and make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Then continue make mesh stitch until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next, for row 2, chain 3, turn and make the mesh stitch until you have 2 last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you have 2 last stitch, then we are going to make the crease by make double crochet 2 together. So after you have chain 1, then continue make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. After you have 2 loops on your hook, then continue make double crochet into the next double crochet stitch. After you have 3 loops on your hook, then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make double crochet 2 together. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And now you must have 17 stitches of double crochet like the front shoulder part. So for this stitch and this chain stitch, we don't count as a stitch. And now my back part is done, and this is what it looks like. Next, we are going to connect both parts together. To begin, attach the yarn into both sides corner. And then chain 1. Then make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet, insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Keep making single crochet into the double crochet stitch and into the chain space until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. Thank you. after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what the right side looks like. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. And now we are done for connecting both sides together. Next, we are going to make the sleeves. Count 17 rows from the shoulder part and then mark it. It is equal 6 inches. If you guys want it bigger, please count more rows and mark it. And this is what my armhole looks like. For my arm circumference, it is equal 12 inches. Like I said, if you guys want it more bigger, please count more rows and mark it. Next, we are going to count the same number to the other side. For the next part, we are going to connect this side together. To begin, attach the yarn into both sides by count 2 chains and insert the hook into the 3rd chain. And then chain 1. Next, we are going to make 2 single crochet into this big space of both sides. Keep repeating this until you reach the stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. After you've reached the stitch near stitch marker, then we are going to make the sleeves. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 1, chain 3. Then make double crochet into this big space. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1 and make double crochet into this big space. Keep repeating this around until you reach the stitch near stitch marker, then I will meet you back again. after you reach the stitch new stitch marker, then remove the stitch marker and we are going to make the bokeh shirt into this big loop that near chain 3. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1. Next, we are going to make slip stitch into the second chain. To make slip stitch, continue inside the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, for row 2, chain 3. Turn your work and make mesh stitch around until you reach the stitch near chain 3 and I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch near chain 3, then chain 1 and continue make slip stitch into the second chain. And this is what it looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 47, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 47. For my sleeve measurement, it is equal 17 inches. If you guys want your sleeve longer, please add more rows. Next, we are going to make the crease around the sleeves. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work. And we are going to make the crease by making single crochet 2 together. To make single crochet 2 together, insert the hook into this chain space. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next chain space. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we make single crochet 2 together. Then make single crochet into the next chain space. After you have made a single crochet, then we are going to make the crease by making single crochet 2 together. Keep repeating this around until you reach the end of the row and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the decreasing stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, and then make slip stitch. Next, we are going to make the ruffle edge. For row 3, chain 3, turn your work and make increase by make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Keep repeating this into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the chain 3 stitch. Next, for row 4, chain 3. Then make double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And this is what my sleeves looks like. Please turn the top right side out. And for the other sleeves, please repeat the same thing like the first sleeves. For the next part, we are going to make single crochet around the neckline and make the front tie. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. Then chain 1. Make single crochet into this big space. Then continue make single crochet into this row. Keep repeating this by making single crochet into this big space and this row until you reach the corner part. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made a single crochet into the corner part, then continue make 70 chains. It is for the front tie. If you guys want it more longer, please add more chains. After you got 70 chains, next we are going to make the mini flower with this front tie. So for this mini flower, I switch the hook. I use 1.5mm crochet hook for crochet the flower. If you guys don't have, it doesn't matter, you can use the same hook. Next, continue add 4 more chains. After you have add 4 more chains, then skip 3 chains and make 2 double crochet into the 4th chain. After you got 2 double crochet in the same loop, then chain 2 and then continue make slip stitch into the same stitch with double crochet. After you have made a slip stitch, then chain 2 and make 2 double crochet into the same stitch. After you have made 2 double crochet, then chain 2 and make slip stitch into the same stitch with double crochet. Keep repeating this until you have 5 petals and I will meet you back again. After you reach the 5th petal, and this is what the flower looks like. Next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into these chains. So I'm gonna switch the hook into the 3mm crochet hook. So keep making slip stitch into every chain until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to continue make single crochet into this corner space, and then continue make single crochet into each big space and each row around the neckline until you reach the other side corner, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the other side corner, then continue make 70 chains and repeat the same thing like the first string. Then I will meet you back again. After you have made the front tight, then continue make single crochet into each stitch until you reach the end of the row, and I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to continue make single crochet into this bottom edge of the cardigan by make single crochet into this big space and into the double crochet stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 1, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Next, we are going to make the ruffle edge. For row 2, chain 3, turn your work and make increase by make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. Keep repeating this into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the ruffle edge looks like. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And now your cardigan almost done. For the next part, we are going to attach the puff flower into the cardigan. I made 12 puff flowers for my cardigan, 6 flowers for both sleeves, and 6 more for the both front side. So for the puff flower tutorial, I will put the link down below at the description. When you attach the flower into the cardigan, please don't pull it too tight. And now the Desi Mesh cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.